Hi children, good afternoon. Let's come from the last previous class. We have learned the poem Ice Cream Man. Okay, I hope you had enjoyed much. Okay, now I would like to tell some grammar part regarding punctuation marks. Okay, these are the punctuation marks. Full stop, comma, question mark, exclamation, hyphen, and round brackets. Okay, let's briefly, I shall explain you one by one. Understand, children? Okay, these are very, very important for when you make a sentence, when you write a paragraph, it gives the meaning. When we use the punctuation marks only, it gives meaningful. Understood? These are the rules we have to learn when you form the passage, when you write the sentence. Understood? Otherwise, grammatically, it is a wrong. You must learn the punctuation marks. Understood? Okay. Now, you shall learn one by one. I give examples. Okay. What is the punctuation marks and why do we need this? Punctuation marks are signs used in writing, show, pauses, and emphasize. These marks help the reader understand the sentence and its meanings. Okay, let us learn. First, full stop. Why you learn? The primary use of full stop is to end sentence. Okay, when you write a sentence, it has to end. It is also useful to write or denote abbreviations. An abbreviation is a short form of a verb. Okay, for example, Mr. Rao was happy to see his wife. The sentence is to keep your post. Every sentence when you write, we have to put full stop. It symbolizes that sentence has finished. Okay. Sentence as finished, you have to pause it there. Okay. Next, abbreviation also. Abbreviation. For example, NASA is NASA. For abbreviations is the shortened formest word. Okay. It is also useful to write denote abbreviation. An abbreviation is the shortened form of word. Okay. Here NASA is there. No need of putting in this abbreviation, especially abbreviation. No need includes full stop. Okay, understood. Next, comma. Comma. Where you have to learn comma. Okay, in case of special words like etc., the full stop is usually followed by comma. Okay. We have learned a few instances where commas are used in previous class and third standard, and here are some. Okay, we use commas to separate two independent parts of sentence. Okay, for example, while I was eating. Okay, the cat scratched at the door while I was eating. Is it wrong? Understood? Okay. Next, some more examples I give for the comma. Okay. You should see the doctor if you are ill. You should see the doctor. comma, if you are ill. Full stop. Okay, is it wrong? Okay, is it wrong? You should see the doctor if you are ill. You should see the doctor in. Understood. For some, note that the comma in two sentences are already connected by conjunctions. So, comma is not required for this sentence. Okay. Because, okay. Note that in two sentences are already connected by conjunctions. Conjunctions means this is already conjunction is there here. If, when you start from sentence, you should see the doctor, comma, if you are ill, no need. Here, since condition came now, no need of putting comma. It's no need of putting comma. Okay. Since here no conjunctions, not started with conjunctions. Okay. Then we can put the no need of here putting comma. Understood? Commas are not required. Already connected by conjunction, so comma is not required. Already. Here conjunction is there, no need of putting comma. Understood? Here they put comma as well as if conjunction is there, that's why no need of putting comma. Okay, next situation 2. Introductory words should be followed by comma. Introductory words like yes, however, well, okay, you have to put comma. Understood? Yes, yes, however, well, okay, you have to put like this, commas, understood? And when you use a pair of commas also, okay, pair of commas in the middle sentence to include the phrase that give additional information to the body, understood? John and ill, couple from next door are coming for dinner tonight, Varun and Taru. Use pair words, Varun and Taru. Pair words, whatever may be, put commas. Understood? Next. Next one. Question mark. Okay, the question mark. Full stop finished. Question comma finished. Next question mark. The question mark is an easy punctuation mark to use. It is placed at the end of the sentence to pose a question. Okay, when we use the question mark, when we ask the question word, what, when, where, how, isn't it? Okay, the question mark. This punctuation mark to use, okay, when we ask the question, it is placed at the end of the sentence. For example, where is the guitar? Where is the guitar? How many people will come to the party? At the end of the sentence, we put the question mark, starting from WH question. Okay? Understood? Okay. I wonder how many people will come to the party? Okay, question mark is not needed here, as in it is when we give the statement. Okay, when we give the statement, I wish, I wonder how many will come, I wonder how many are there, who are going. Okay, when we give statement, it's no need of putting question mark. Okay. When we ask the questions, only you have to put the question mark. Okay. We'll continue next class. Okay. Have a nice day. Hi children, welcome to the next class. We have been learning the grammar, punctuations, isn't it? Punctuations, marks. The first we have learned the full stop, isn't it? When we have to use the full stop, when are the end of the sentence? If the sentence is going to finish, you have to use the full stop, isn't it? Next we have learned the question mark. Sorry, yeah, question mark we have learned. Question mark, when we ask the question, we have to put the, at the end of the sentence, we have to put the question mark, okay? Whichever start the what, how, where, we have to put the question mark. Understood? Then, we have learned the comma, okay? Before the previous class, we have learned the commas. Commas are separated to two independent parts of the sentence, isn't it? Okay? While I was eating, comma, the cat scratched the door. Two independent sentences. Okay. If the conjunction starts with the sentence, no need of putting comma. Okay. Next, pair of commas also. Pair of commas. Pair of commas. No need of using. You have to use, sorry. John and Jill, comma. Okay. Varun and Tarun, comma. Sons of Mr. Raj went to the same school, comma. Okay. Next word, third word, fourth word, exclamatory. Exclamatory marks, an exclamatory marks is used to show a vast range of emotions such as love, anger, happiness, confusion, etc., etc. Understood? Etc., etc. We use in strong feelings. For example, fantastic, comma, we close the day. Exclamatory mark. Fantastic, comma. We close the door. Okay. Fantastic, comma, we close the day. Fantastic. Exclamation mark. We close the day. Full stop. Let's have an observe. We can use exclamatory mark at the beginning. Okay. Then, or at the end also we can use. Okay. Next. In certain instances, we use only exclamatory words to express the thought, feeling, emotions. At such times, the words thing is followed by exclamation mark. Okay, some exclamation mark. Wow, brilliant, awesome, ouch, amazing, bravo, fantastic, eureka, hooray, magnificent, unbelievable. Understood? Wow, brilliant, wow, okay, what a beautiful scene it is, brilliant, what a hit in the sixer, awesome, your dress is very nice, ouch, it's paining, amazing to see you all here, isn't it, bravo, you have won the, bravo, you defeated that man, fantastic. You have danced well. Tremendous. Eureka. Hooray. We won the match. Unbelievable. Okay. An exclamation mark is used to sentence that express a command. Command also we can use. Come here. Come here now. Exclamation mark. Be sure you don't use exclamation mark if you are using please. Okay. When you use please or request, don't know it of using exclamation mark. Okay. Next. iPhone. Next. iPhone. Next. iPhone. iPhone is used to join two or more words serving as a single adjective. Okay, single adjective. When we use both adjectives to make we put in between hyphen and make one adjective before a noun. That also before a noun we put hyphen. Okay, like the peanuts are chocolate covered. Example, the peanuts are chocolate covered. Because here the before adjective, okay, the peanuts are chocolate covered. Okay, here we shouldn't use hyphen. Why? Because before a single adjective, the peanuts are adjective, and chocolate is a verb. Understood? Chocolate is a verb. Okay, hyphen is used to join two or more words serving as a single adjective before a noun. We
should not do like this. Chocolate covered peanuts. We should not put. Okay, chocolate covered with peanuts. Okay, chocolate covered peanuts. Before an adjective, you should put comma. Chocolate is here adjective. Before that, you have to put the comma. Okay, don't use the hyphen if the noun comes first. Okay, here this is a noun. That's why we do not use the comma. Understood? Here this is adjective. That's why we have used hyphen. Understood? Okay. Hyphen is used joined to more two or more words serving as a single adjective before a noun. Okay. Next, use hyphen with compound numbers. Compound numbers for 40, 5, 50, 6. Okay. Like that, compound numbers also they can use the hyphen. Next, he had to resign the contract. Okay, he had to resign his job, not resign. In some, not to be used, confused the words resign. It is a resign. It is a single word. I love to eat ice cream. Ice cream also you can use. Ice cream. Okay, compound nouns. Ice cream. Okay. Use icon with prefix such as ex minister. Self-assured. All in pursuit. Okay, before prefix words. Before prefix words, we use hyphens. Understood? Okay. Once again, I'll tell. Hyphen is used to join two or more words serving as a single adjective noun. Okay. Don't use hyphen if the noun comes first. Here noun came, that's why we did not use any hyphen. The peanuts are chocolate, we did not use hyphen. Here chocolate covered peanuts because our chocolate is an adjective. Next, compound numbers 45, 46, we have to use hyphens. Next, before prefix. Okay, illegal. Okay, like that we have to use hyphen words. Okay, the first, before a noun you have to use hyphen. Next, Then compound numbers comes, we have to use I for. Then compound words comes, we have to use I for. Before prefix, we have to use I for. Okay, children, learn and make use when you write the sentences and passages. Understood? When you write the sentences, where while you read also, you have to use this punctuation marks. Okay, we'll cover. We'll meet in the next class. Okay, thank you. Have a good day.